Continuing from last video, we're going to look at some spin-off shorts that came after Who Framed Roger Rabbit, Tummy Trouble, Roller Coaster Rabbit, and Trail Mix-Up. Released in 1989, 1990, and 1993 respectively, these were 7 to 8 minute long shorts that played before a theatrical film. They eventually had a home video release thanks to Disney, Amblin Entertainment, and Touchstone Pictures. And the first two share the same directors, Rob Minkoff and Frank Marshall. There were plans for more, but they ended up being canceled. We'll get into those reasons soon enough. For now, let us begin the short-lived spin-offs of Roger Rabbit. First up, Tummy Trouble. Like the other two shorts, it'll use the format of the Roger Rabbit and Baby Herman cartoon from the movie. But because Maroon bit the bullet, Disney and Steven Spielberg are introducing the cartoons. Well, except the second short. That one replaced Disney with Touchstone Pictures until 2013. In any case, all three follow the same setup. Baby Herman's mother decides to leave Roger behind with the baby, and it's clear that she's just a hostile and negligent parent.
And everything's going to be just fine. Not like last time!
You'll stay here with baby, or it's rabbit stew for dinner!
And remember, if you get into any trouble,
rabbit season opens today!
And considering the time period, how much do you want to bet she keeps him as her personal slave? Roger then tries to calm Herman down with a rattle, but then the baby does something shocking.
Jason, somebody call 911! Call 911!
Good thing Benny's cousin Ambi was on the scene. Poor Roger, acting like a drama queen even though baby Herman is fine. He just wants his milk bottle.
Bye, baby, on the treetop. Oh, oh,
oh. Well, that was easy. Time to go home. No, of course not. Because it's Roger's turn to swallow the rattle. At least he makes the best of it.
Yep, this is him.
Hey, what's going on?
It's times like this that I really enjoy the details the animators can get away with. So while Roger's screwed, we see that his wife became a nurse here. And knowing how Baby Herman actually is, he must be really good at hiding his horniness.
My problem is I got a 50-year-old lust and a 3-year-old dinky.
Honestly, this short, and by extension the others, does a great job with the various character reactions, which harkens back to the more chaotic and expressive origins of animation. Like Baby Herman causing an atomic laser to shoot out, which causes syringe needles to come out and eventually hit Roger. A rocket sends them flying down a hall. They fall into an elevator shaft. Just so much chaos. And that's what makes them so fun. Sure, as time goes on, there might be things from this era that haven't aged well, but it's well-done slapstick humor with just the right amount of violence.
Baby Herman, I'll catch ya!
Gruesome, isn't it, folks?
Also, Droopy's in all three of these shorts. I don't know how the rights for him work, but he's a reminder that this is a crossover universe. The chaos goes as far as Roger and Baby Herman being shot up into the stratosphere, only to come crashing down many floors. But hey, at least the rattle's finally out of Baby Herman.
Thank goodness for modern medicine!
Oh, that baby Herman. And here is the one and only time that one of these shorts has an ending, because no one screwed up in the end. And like the movie, the live-action animated bits are integrated near seamlessly.
Roger, honey bunny,
let's go home and play.
Tippin, what do we play? Tiddlywink, canasta, parteezy?
Oh, how about a little patty cake instead?
Patty cake?
Oh, baby, sexy patty cake time! Next up, Roller Coaster Rabbit. Now, even though this one has the same sort of opening, they still add some extra credits during the episode itself. Kinda weird, but whatever. This time, everyone is at a fair, and Mrs. Herman decides to leave Roger for a psychic reading. Given that last time she left them for an hour, but never came back, I wonder how long she'll be gone for here. Anyway, Roger's screw-up comes from letting Herman's balloon get away.
Uncle Roger, we'll get you a new balloon! Now you stay here and be a good boy and don't get into any trouble! Promise?
But baby Herman starts making his way over to a red balloon on a dartboard. Roger then realizes that he lost Herman. But before he tracks the baby down... He goes after Herman after spotting him, and thus the chaos begins again. We get some good ones, like darts to the head.
Oh hey, what's happening to my head? I got a headache, but it's just a little one.
Getting shot at a shooting gallery after telling them to hold.
Fire away!
Getting caught on Ferris wheel gears, getting beat up by a prize fighting bull, and of course, the piece de resistance. The roller coaster. While the roller coaster setup limits the gags you can use, I still dig its size and scale. That, and it's totally unsafe to ride on. And speaking of unsafe, there's a moment where they nearly fly out of the picture. Literally. And because it's flashing so much, it could probably cause damage. Oh, and speaking of Jessica...
Save me!
Curses. Foiled again.
They must really love Droopy. Now, earlier I said that Tummy Trouble was the only one with a proper ending. And that's because after going through the terror tunnel, this happens. Why are you so evil-looking, Mr. Fireman? The director is pissed that he lost a whole scene, though it looks like the whole short was lost. So, Roger's gotta do it all over again.
Not this head, Q-Ball.
Frankly, I agree. Not worth it a second time. Still funny, though. Now, it's at around this point that Steven Spielberg and Michael Eisner argued about where to put this particular short. Either putting it before Arachnophobia or Dick Tracy. The latter won out, causing Spielberg to cancel another short in response. Thus, we come to the third and final short to ever be produced, Trail Mix-Up. Unlike the first two, this one has a different director, Barry Cook, and it's the only one to be composted digitally using Disney's CAPS system. It starts out nice and peaceful, until we see the result of human deforestation. Yellowstone National Park! Ha! Naturally, the mother is forcing Roger to do all the hard work.
Cookie!
Roger, you pin-headed klutz!
It's time your crazy shenanigans came to an end!
You cannot convince me that Roger is anything but a slave to her. This time, she goes hunting. And if he screws up, it's rabbit season. While she's gone, he tries to start a campfire. But his wife visits during her rounds as a forest ranger.
Need any help, little camper?
Of course not! I'm a regular mountain man! Oh man! Talk about babes in the woods!
I must say... You do look like you know what you're doing.
Knowing that these two are married, it takes a lot to pretend that you aren't during production. Yet I wouldn't be surprised if his sex drive is always like this.
And remember, only you can prevent forest fires.
Guess he couldn't hold it in. This time, we start with Baby Herman messing with nature, which causes stuff to happen to Roger. He destroys part of the forest using Minkoff, likely in reference to Rob Minkoff. He gets his head stuck in a beehive that falls on him, while Baby Herman climbs up a tree. He has a run-in with a lake shark that's actually Droopy. Again. And then, of course, when a beaver shows up to eat trees, he tries to get out of the way.
Phew, I made it!
Man, Roger must have the worst luck in the world. That or he spent it all getting Jessica Rabbit to marry him. Oh, the fun to be had at the sawmill. And all because Baby Herman really wants that beaver. And it leads to a spiritual successor of the roller coaster scene from the last short. The Log Flume Ride from Hell.
Oh, no!
I love how nearly the entire time, the beaver has the same expression of boredom. Like, this is just another day in the office for him. At least until they start landing in old predictable geyser. Oh! Of course, and yet another improper ending. They get blasted out of the studio! Guess the director didn't count on the pressure being that high, but at least it leads to my favorite moment of all. They destroyed Mount Rushmore! Hooray!
Yes! Kill!
I was not expecting that. Wow.
Oh! It went kaboom!
Yeah!
This contest is over. Give that man the $10,000.
USA! 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 USA!
Oh my God, Roger's... Roger's clothes!
You ruined the national monument!
Oh, it was an eyesore anyway. No one will miss it.
It's not like it's the end of the world.
Well, that happened. Anyway, that's all three shorts. There were going to be three more on top of the one that was canned, but they got canceled during the planning stages. Which is a shame because the shorts we got were pretty enjoyable. I liked the idea of having them come out at least once a year to give people time to plan out the next one. We could still get them. Seeing how cartoons these days follow their own brand of zany chaos to mimic older cartoons. Anyway, aside from a few film cameos, video games, and Disney theme park attractions, Roger Rabbit wouldn't get much follow-up in the way of a major animated production. There were talks of sequels and even a prequel to the original film, but according to Zemeckis, the only thing stopping him from doing anything is Disney, as they lost interest in Roger Rabbit, except as cameo fodder, like for the upcoming Chip and Dale movie. Some people online have believed that the 1993 cartoon series, Bonkers, was originally going to be a Roger Rabbit cartoon, but producer Greg Wiseman shot down that suggestion. Honestly, it would have been better to keep Roger in cartoon short form. Maybe one day I'll give the books a read over. Otherwise, we still have the movies and cartoons to tide us over until the day we do see Roger Rabbit in anything that isn't a cameo. Now, next time, you'll be in for a treat. Because of current circumstances, I got a couple films to show you. One of them being... You want me to review what? Yeah, no thanks.
same old thing. They never pay me enough money. You wanna pay peanuts, you get monkeys. I can't take much more of this. I get the same junk from that rabbit every time we do something. He's making me crazy.
Mr. Herman, you forgot something.
What's the matter, Toots? Afraid of a little bang?